Friends of Father George Clements are speaking out tonight as they remember the popular priest who died earlier today.
WGN's Tanya Francisco's live outside Holy Angels Church in Bronzeville with more on his life. Hi, Tanya.
Hey there, Micah and Joe. Yeah, Father George Clements was the longtime pastor here at Holy Angels Church. In fact, the church in the street in front of the church is named for him, Father George Clements Boulevard. Well, today, at age 87, he passed away after a long legacy of fighting for those who could not fight for themselves.
I lost a great father today. I lost a great man today.
An emotional Friday Clements talking about his adopted father, George Clements. The legendary activist priest passed away this morning after having suffered a heart attack and a stroke last month. Father Clements, a black Roman Catholic priest who was a civil rights activist who had an open door policy, willing to help any and all who showed up on his doorstep. In 1980, he adopted the first of his four sons after being made aware of the number of homeless black children. He went on to create the One Church, One Child program, which has now seen over 400,000 children across the country find forever homes. Joey Clements was the first son he adopted when he was 12 years old.
He was so proud. He loved being a priest above anything else.
George Clements made black Catholics proud to be black Catholic. He was a pioneering voice when black Catholics felt excluded, forgotten, ignored in the Catholic Church. George Clements fought to make sure that black Catholics had a place at the table, and he made black Catholics proud to be who they were.
Now, in August of this year, the Archdiocese of Chicago announced an allegation of abuse had been made against Father Clements dating back to 1974. DCFS says it has since closed that investigation, noting that it can only investigate a current child victim and cannot look into past claims of abuse. Coming up at 6 o'clock tonight, his sons react to that allegation and tell us how Father Clements was reacting to that allegation, obviously being made before he took ill. I'll have that coming up at 6 o'clock. But for now, I'm live this evening in Bronzeville. Tanya Francisco, WGN News.
Yeah, despite everything, he did leave quite a legacy. Thank you, Tanya.
Yes.